Joe Lyons here from the Automator, and a lot of you guys have seen while I'm, you know, doing stuff in my videos, I bring up this little menu, and it's called Quick Access Popup. And I did a survey actually, and I was really surprised to see how many of my subscribers weren't aware of what it was or how it worked. And so I asked Jean Lalonde here to join me. He's the author of QAP, and to, you know, take a step into it. Let's go through some of the main benefits of like why people would want to use it and how it can help them. So thanks, Jean, for joining me today.
Hi, Joe. Thank you.
So, yeah, so let's get into it. What is like the main benefits of someone with using QAP? I know for me, you know, there's some very clear stuff. For you, what would you say the main benefit is?
I would say it's a tool that will help users to find what they need to use now quickly, easily, with the less possible number of clicks to get to that. And it can be to access folders where you have your documents. It can be documents themselves. It can be application, websites. It can also be special folders in Windows, for example, the download folder. Sometimes you search, how can I get my download folder? So it's presented as a menu with submenu. I will be able to show it to you, where you can group the things that you use. And what is good is that you can group them by the way you use them, not necessarily the way they are split among several folders in Windows, because you have this type of documents in a folder and this type of application in another folder. So you can really group this. And there's a lot on top of that to make things as quick as possible. For example, to launch three documents at the same time, or one document, one folder, and one website, because you have to use them together. So you structure your content by tasks, by projects, by subjects, the way you need to use them. There's a lot more. There's stuff for more advanced users, for more power users, but the basic of Quick Access Popup is aimed at every user that manage documents, manage content that they have to access frequently on their computer.
Yeah, I would restate what you were saying. At least one thing is that it allows you to group things together, to organize things in a way that makes sense to you. Not you. I think you said how you use them, which is true, but to me, more refined is like, it's how it makes sense to however you want it, you can structure them in ways. And even if you have other people that are doing that work with you on a daily basis, you might like to think of things slightly different. And the fact is, especially when you work in corporate America, you have these deeply nested network drives that take you 5 to 8 clicks easily to get to. And this makes that, it does away with all of that and the yeah. things. And like you said, you can launch multiple things at once, which is
it also adapts to the way you like to use your computer. Some users are mouse intensive, so they will want to make everything with their mouse. Others are keyboard, so you can create mouse shortcuts. You can use the menu to go to submenus, or you can use the keyboard to launch a document, or just to open a submenu with something very specific to what you want to do. If you type a lot of text that is repetitive, it can help you to create text snippets, so small pieces of text that you can type with just a few keystrokes or a mouse click. So we will not be able, we have maybe 10 minutes, we said, Joe, well, I won't be able to show everything, but if you want, I can just open my demo environment to show, give you an idea of what it looks like.
Yeah, let's take a look at the tool. I was going to say, for me, or if you're like, you do both, you want the both mouse or keyboard, you know, I use both, and it really has more to do with the frequency of how often I do the thing will be in where my hands are located, right? And so I love having either approach available.
Yeah. So this is the window where you manage the content of your menu, but you don't have to use it. It can be closed. What you use all the time is the pop-up menu itself. So there are things that are there because you put it there because you use it and you want to put your favorite contents in it. But there's also dynamic content. So things that are automatically put in this menu because you just used them recently. So the in the works submenu here will show you the recent folders that you used on your computer. The 10 most recent, you can increase that if you would like. The 10 most recent files that you opened with your computer. And here are the most frequently used folders or files. So it's kind of a hit parade of your content on your computer. And finally, you have the current windows. So windows that are currently open on my computer, and I can activate that and jump to any of these folder or application in a second. So this is the something that is built in with Quick Access Popup that you can adapt if you prefer to change the way it is presented. And here you have example of submenus containing documents, folders, or applications that I or websites that I put there because I would need to use them frequently. So for example, folder here, you can have visual indication of your important content by using icons. So there are standard icons like this one, which is a standard folder icon, but you can replace it with something more meaningful for you, making it easier to locate your content in the menu. You can have sub menus. You can have no icons if you prefer in some menus to have no icons. So there are a lot of things, and there are groups. So for each of these items, if I click on it, it will open the folder that I selected. It will be a little slow on this computer because it's a virtual machine that is a little bit slow. So I open this folder here with the list of clients, which was the folder that I selected. And when I am inside this folder, I can change the folder inside this Explorer window. So if I go to my folder, does not exist. Sorry about that. It's an old demo thing that I... So let's use my project folder here. So it will change the folder inside the current Explorer. So it can be used to open a new window, or it can be used to navigate inside a window. And even inside dialog boxes, when you are in a file open dialog box, you can also change folder in a second from there, instead of having to browse, you know, in the save as folder, the save as dialog box in an application is never at the place you need it to be. So you always have to go up and down and find in which network or, you know. So if everything is that you need every day or every week is in this menu, you can click open the menu in the dialog box and it will take you to where you need to save your file instantly.
Yeah, so let me interrupt you there for those that aren't quite getting it. Anytime like I'm in, let's say Chrome or Word, you know, and I go to open or save a file, when that dialog box that pops up, that's where you need to navigate, you know, to that network driver folder, wherever you do. And that's what he's saying is like, it will automatically recognize you're in that menu window and navigate in that folder to where you want it to go. And I use that. I can't tell you how many times a day I use that functionality. It's awesome.
So I'll open Notepad here. And when you say save as, of course, it's an empty file, but just for the demonstration. Here, of course, I am the folder, the client folder, but I could go elsewhere and navigate. But if I want to go quickly somewhere, I can open the menu inside the dialog box and say that I want to open my project folders, and it will change the folder immediately, and I'm ready to save my file. You have a lot of clients, a lot of projects, a lot of applications, you will find it very efficient to use this type of menu to manage your content.
What I was going to interrupt you there for is to say, now, if you have one that you use a lot, that's where assigning like a hotkey to that thing is so much faster than using the GUI. The GUI I use as a visual reminder when I, for things I don't use that often, I can still not access it in a way that makes sense to me. But when there's one that you use very frequently, you can assign like a hotkey or even a hot string in that case to pull it up, and it saves so much.
And I can show you in the menu, there are some menu items that have a hotkey. For example, the customized window, you can hit Shift Control C to get to the Quick Access Popup website, Shift Control Q. So these are examples. And if I want to show you how easy it is to add one, if I go to my project, let's take this one, my project charter here, I need to open it frequently. So I can go in the menu options here, and under shortcut, I can change and say that Shift Control T, for example, is now written here. When I save, and I can now press Shift Control T, and it will launch the folder that I selected. Okay. So it's very easy to manage your menu using this dialog box. I can do a quick tour. So you have first the main menu. You can go to any submenu that you created. You can also go to the submenu by double clicking in the menus. You can go back here. If you want to move items, you can use the arrow keys here to move items, or just drag and drop if you prefer to move items using drag and drop. You have buttons here to add a new item. So it can be a folder, a special folder, which is a Windows special folder like downloads, network, a lot of stuff that system administrator or power user will love using. There are about 50 special folders available there. I can just show it to you quickly here. So you have all these items here grouped by categories. So these are the special folders, documents, application, Windows apps, which is a new kind of window, an application that Windows has that comes from the Windows Store. Links, so websites or any type of URLs, FTP site, snippets, which would take a minute to talk about that, QAP features, which are various things that are created inside Quick Access Popup and that are, for example, dynamic menus like the frequent files that we've seen earlier, some tools to close all windows, for instance, a lot of things that are available inside Quick Access Popup and that you can add to your menu. Not everything is in the menu at first because your menu it will be overwhelming, but as you discover how to use things and how what to want to see what else it can do, so you can add these quick access pop-up features here. You can create a submenu, so a submenu will group things. Your items. A shared menu, which is a submenu, but that can be shared with other users if you have a network drive or a Dropbox drive, for example, where you can share a menu so you can use the same content, all the members of this group. And the group, I'll just show you how to use to launch a group. I'll just discard my changes for now. So a group is when you have a task that requires, for example, that you open a folder, a document, and a document like an Excel file and a website where you will manage some transaction and you need to copy things from one to the other. So when you know that you have to do that, you can go here and in this example here, you have a group of window. There's a small tree between brackets here. It tells you that there are three items that will be launched here. So if I click this, it will open a folder. It will take a few seconds because of the speed of my machine here. So it opens a text file, it opens a website, and it opens a folder. So we have the folder here, and the website will come in a second. Sorry for the speed of this virtual machine.
Cool. This is awesome.
Yeah. So this is the website that was part of this group. Yeah. There's so much we can see, but maybe because we don't want to take too much time today is to show you how you can use snippets to make some pieces of text that you type frequently, how to display them very quickly. So I'll just restart Notepad here. Come on. Okay. And let's say that I have to type my address. So instead of typing the whole address, if I have to type it frequently, I can type, I can first use the menu, quick access pop-up menu, and go in my snippets and say that I want to type the address. It will type the address that way. This is a short address. The normal address would be longer and you would save more clicks, more keystrokes. But what can also be done to write this piece of text is to enter what is called a trigger, okay? And in my case, I'm using comma ADR, and automatically comma ADR, you will see that it will be replaced with the address. I'm showing you a very short example, but it can be a very long URL. It can be a very long address. It can be a paragraph that you use frequently in your communications. These snippets can include variables or can include things like waiting for you to enter, for example, the name of the person you are writing to, and this name will be inserted at the place you wish inside the snippet. So there's a lot of stuff there that can be can make you save a lot of time using snippets.
Cool. Yeah, and we've done videos in the past describing the tool. It's you're on what version now?
11.3.
Okay, yeah, and I know there were some major upgrades and changes that we're going to discuss later in some other videos, some of the changes that have been done. For those of you who aren't familiar, you see me using the GUIs, this is the tool, this is my secret, right, for saving a lot of time. I can't tell you how many times a day I use it, especially like because I have my website and I'm posting stuff, and I have most of my pages, links to pages on my site. So that way when I'm in, I'm trying to reply to somebody and link to like the webinars or to Chrome, I have that URL stored for me and I can dump them in there. Or let's say I record a new video and I want to share it to like the 10 different places that I share my stuff. I hit one thing and it loads all 10 pages for me. And I have my little snippet I post into them. So it saves a ton of time.
Yeah, it's very efficient. Show you the Quick Access Popup website. There's a lot of information there if you want to find out more about this product.
Yeah, and there's several different ways to get it licensing wise, right? Some are paid, some are free with a little bit reduced functionality. Is that right?
Yeah, yeah. There's a free edition that you can try, and you can upgrade easily to monthly, yearly subscription or lifetime license if you prefer to pay only once.
But they're all, to me, very reasonably priced where it's not cost prohibitive. So
yeah.
Awesome, John. Thank you so much for joining.
Thank you very much, Joe. Bye-bye.
Hey, so thanks for watching that video with Jean Lalonde. And he's a great guy. And after the video, I said, hey, how about offering a discount coupon? And so what we agreed on was, because, of course, videos, get watched later, he gave me a coupon code, which I'm going to add on my webpage. But you can go to this URL, and which will be above me here, and you can see if there's an active coupon for you or not. So right now this coupon's good till the end of May, but who knows when you actually watch the video. But again, we have coupon discounts available at different times. So hope that helps. And I love QAP. I can't stress enough, give it a try. It'll save you a ton of time. Cheers.